that connection.
You're going to leave.
Go. See, there is the answer.
To persuade.
Yeah. Because you all want to be the leaders. That's why I want to congratulate you. That you are in the right place on the right time. What Toastmaster teaches you? Two things, correct? You have a competent communicator manual, and what's the other one?
Leadership
manual. That's what they teach you. So communication makes you more influential, and it's a process. That's why they have the whole process to go through to become a better leader. There's no quick fix. Zach say, oh, I just did my icebreaker, now I'm the leader. No, you need to go through a little more. So that's my law of process. And this is the place where you can learn, where you learn communication. Not only public speaking, like I mentioned you, communication is a two-way skill. Speaking and listening. Speaking is sharing, listening is caring. People don't care how much do you know, but people do know how much do you care. So you have to learn listening first. Right? That's why God gave you 2 years and 1 month. So you have to learn to listen first. And these two skills, especially communication, improves your two skills in your life. Number one, people skills. You are good in communication, you will be a better people person. Why people skill is more important? Anybody can answer. You're in sales, you also. Tell me, please.
Well, you need to understand people. So, you know, they have to be appreciated, understood, and then you have to articulate back what you heard so you can validate their feelings.
So let me give you an example. Perfect answer. If you see the structure of any company, any organization, from bottom to the middle, all the skilled people are working. They're sitting in their cubes, they're operating machines. Do you think they are not skilled? They all are skilled. I can't operate those machines. But when you go from middle to the up, top, the people who are getting paid the most are people. They are talking on phone, they are persuading, they are influencing, they are negotiating. So where do you want to be? In the upper half or lower half? That's your decision. The second skill which you improve with this Toastmaster and communication is selling skills. Now people say, I don't want to be a salesperson. Correct? Most of the people think like that. But my question is, who's not selling? Since you wake up in the morning till you go to the bed, you talk, you negotiate, you persuade, you influence people. What is that all about? A boy is proposing a girl to get married, what he's trying to do? Tell me. What he's trying to do? He's selling himself. All right? An attorney who's arguing in front of a judge in the court for his client, what he's intended to do? A person who's walking in your office for a job interview, what he's looking for? Sell himself. So we all sell either for or against ourselves. So we have to improve those skills. We have to learn the communication. And communication makes you the best in terms of influence, in terms of leadership. And leadership requires these things. If you don't have those two skills, you cannot survive. We cannot succeed in this 21st century. So we have to start the process. We have to ask ourselves every single morning when we wake up and when we go to bed. I do my exercise, you can do yours. I have 3 questions to ask myself every single night before I go to bed. Number one, did I learn something new today? Which I didn't know yesterday. A new English word, because this is not my first or second language, this is my third language. It may be a new gesture. Something new I had to learn. Then, did I help someone today? It may be a smile. It because he has a bad day, and I smile and I talk politely that made his day. Did I help someone? And last but not the least, I ask myself, can I sleep right? If I have done those two things, I can sleep right. And 365 days later, if you will see me, or we are going to run into each other, and you will say, "Father, you are just like the way you were last year. Do you think I'll be happy?" I learned 365 new things. And I helped 365 people in this world. How you can claim that I'm the same one? So we all have to. I will open up with a Q&A session of this because I believe it's almost time for you guys. So feel free to ask any question that comes in your mind. I will try my level best to answer.
You said people don't know how much you know, but they know how much you care. What do you mean by that? In terms of that, do you mean that in the context of sales or relationships, or that people can sense your tone more than your knowledge? Is that what you meant by that?
Great question. I'm talking about communication, listening, and speaking. When I speak, what I'm doing, I'm just throwing the knowledge which I already have. Correct? That's why I'm speaking. But if you are listening, you are learning something new, which is a better way to go. I want to learn something new rather than throwing the same thing which I already have. So speaking, which I am doing, is sharing with you. But you are listening to me, you are caring for me. Because you care, that's why you are listening. Otherwise you didn't need to listen. You could walk away. So people don't care how much do you know, but people do know how much do you care. Everybody loves a person who cares for them. Why do you love your mom and dad? Because they are the most caring people in the world. Nobody else could. Am I right? Any other question?
A question.
Yes.
So you talked a lot about the importance of communication and how it makes a good leader. Why do you think it's so easy for people to forget about how important communication is?
If you heard earlier part of my speech, we all are born to lead, but most of us, we end up in following. Okay? So it's not meant for everyone, although they are born to lead, but that's why they end up in following, because they don't learn and they forget to learn. Why you are in Toastmaster and the rest of the conscience is not? Same way. Because you want to be a leader, they don't. They are better drinking beer right at the bar rather than coming here and learning something new. It's a matter of choice. And most of the people, if they don't think, they don't get it. But you will. Law of process means you have to learn consistency. People always underestimate the power of consistency. They always underestimate what you can do in so many days versus what they can do in one day. It's called law of five to me. I mean, I study like this. You have an axe and you have a tree in your backyard. You get out every morning and do five times, and that's it. You're doing consistent without any missing any day. What do you think the tree is going to be? Where the tree is going to be? It's going to fall down at once. Not in a day, but it may take 1 year. It may take, depend on the size of the tree. But one day, You said, oh, I'm going to take this tree away. And you work like 5 hours. The next 5 days, you are sick. And you're so tired, you don't even dare to go back and do the rest. So my point is, it's not a quick fix. Leadership is not a quick fix. It's a daily routine you have to develop in your personality. Leaders are very disciplined people, if you are a good leader. And the best part is, if you want to be a good leader, you don't look for followers, like I mentioned. Those are the bad leaders. They are looking just to follow. They think it's a privilege. No. Good leaders are adding value to others. That's a good leadership. You are making others to become a leader. And that's called law of explosive growth. When you add in your team, like in this club, club is growing, and you are a good leader, but you are adding value, but you are adding. But when you develop 5 other leaders just like yourself, it's going to multiply. Because everyone is going to do the same thing that you are doing, to grow. So that's how law of explosive growth. So if you need explosive growth in your business, in your corporation, in your any segment of your life, you have to develop others to take the charge so they can multiply. Any other question?
I have one last question now.
Yes.
So what is the difference between a leader and a boss? Because I did come across when I was researching, there was something different between a leader and a boss. Just like your take on that.
A boss is a person who got appointed to be a boss. All right. Leaders cannot be appointed. Leader cannot be asked for to follow you. You have to earn it as a leader. Leadership means you have to earn it, the respect, the influence, like I said, influence. So the whole thing is, boss is a manager, in other words. He's managing you, he's not leading you. And it's a total different subject, and I know your leader, PJ, is expert on that subject, and we have a lot of these discussions that 5 levels of leadership. Maybe she spoke here or not, I don't know about this. And I love to speak with her in a seminar or workshop together because she's very expert on that. There are 5 levels of leadership, which answers your question. And I'm going to go in briefly in just 60 seconds. So I'm not going to talk this. The first level is called position leader. Means I hired you as a manager, so you have a right to tell people to do this and that. Do you think you are a leader? It's just a position, right? The second level is called permission. You build a relationship with your team, so that's called, and they will come to you and they said, oh, sir, now we have a good relationship, you have a position, do you want me to do something? Correct? It happens all the time. Because you have a good relationship with your boss, but you ask yourself. So that's called permission leadership. The third level is called production leadership. I have position, I got your permission, now I'm going to show you how to do it. See my productivity, and you can be successful like me. That's called production. The fourth one is people development. I'm going to say, okay, about it. I did this, you saw me, I can do all that. I will teach you how to do the same things and you do your own. Correct? So now you are at the fourth, last and the final, which is called pinnacle. But technically, you have done so long for so many that you don't have to do anything and everybody will do for you. That's called pinnacle. For example, Mother Teresa, Martin Luther King, all these giant leaders around the world, they developed those leaders around the entire world. And now they are taking care of those jobs, but they still they are leaders. So boss is not a leader until unless he doesn't go through those stages. Make sense?
Sure, thanks.
Anybody else?